Hello friends, welcome to our channel. Today we'll discuss about the distributed system. क्या होता है distribution system और क्या उसकी definition है, क्या उसके characteristics हैं. First video में हमने बहुत सारी चीज़ें देखी थी कि क्या उसके significance हैं, क्या इसके centralized system क्या होता है, distributed system क्या होता है. Now we will see the related to exam perspective, what is the concept of distributed system and how we will describe all kind of the things are related to distributed system. So that is the distributed system concept, the system that having or on autonomous system and communicate through by passing the message across the globe. So that is the definition of the distributed system. And in the next slide we will see here there are the two or three types of the different types of the distributed system definition and how we will explore the distributed system you will see here. So the major issue in this distributed system concept, the first one is the no global clock, because suppose we are sending a message from India to USA or UK, any country, so there will be a difference between the GMT. For example, suppose abhi yahan par 7 o'clock time है, हो सकता है US में 11 o'clock हो, morning time हो. So that is the difference between the global clock and the components fail independently of an another, but we will not see or we will not realize that system have to be crossed or failure. So why which the because we will not realize, because the everything is in the motion or everything will be in cohesion as in proper manner. So there is no issue of such type. Now the another definition, when the system crashes, computer will never heard to stops all the execution of the process, because the all the interdependency are the different mode. Now that is the exact definition of the, or we can say that is the working definition of the distributed system, that is a collection of entities and each of which is an autonomous, programmable or asynchronous, failure prone, and which by which communicate through an unreliable communication medium using a message passing. So that is the exact definition of the distributed system by which we can describe the distributed system, what is the distributed system and how it works. So what is the meaning of the entity? So entity means here the process on a device like the PC, PDA, anything else. Now the this is the architecture of the distributed system. In this you will see here there are the three types of the layer. First one is the top layer, that is the application layer. So you will see here A, application A, B and C. So these are the system by which user interact with the system. Now the that is the middle layer by which all the software and hardware, so that is the layer by which software and hardware or user interact with the system. So that is the distributed system layer, that is also known as the middleware. Now the third one is the local operating system, so that is the operating system as a system software, and in the that is the network LAN by which LAN when it may be possible. So that is the architecture of the distributed system by which user can interact through one to many, many to one. There may be many possibility relation. Now so these are the characteristics features of the distributed system. So first one is the resource sharing of the hardware software. For example, you can attach a printer in the LAN cable and through by which all users are able to execute the operation or can take the printout as per your convenience when the resources are available. Concurrency, simultaneously execution of the program. Scalability, we can scalable. So what is the capability of each and every system, and what is here the concept comes around the about the concept capability of the network. So that is that in the network concept we will see here in the later. throughput, fault tolerance, what is the capacity of tolerance, what is the limitations and delimitations. So these are the various types of constraints we will see, we will discuss in the later part. So these are the characteristics of the distributed system. Now the advantage of the distributed system, these are the that we have already described or discussed in the section of the characteristics. So there will be lots of the advantage or pros of the distributed system. So first one is the reliability. Exactly, अगर एक सिस्टम फेल होता है तो यूजर्स को फील नहीं होता है, पता है नहीं चल पाता है, क्योंकि उसकी सर्विसेज एग्जीक्यूट करती रहती है, वो उसको वेट नहीं करना पड़ता है. सो दैट इज़ द ब्यूटी ऑफ द डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड सिस्टम कि यूजर को पता नहीं पड़ता कि कब वो सिस्टम सर्वर का फेल हो गया और कब उसकी रिकवरी हो गई और सारा लोड बैलेंस दूसरा सिस्टम उसकी सारी प्रोसेस एग्जीक्यूट करने लगता है. शेयरिंग ऑफ रिसोर्सिंग, दैट इज़ द वेरी नाइस थिंग. एग्रीगेट कंप्यूटिंग पावर, दैट इज़ द वेरी नाइस. And openness, scalability, so these are the very most popular, or you can say that is the most important things or significance of the distributed system. Reliability, sharing of the resources, computing power and openness and scalability. So these are the things. Now the disadvantage, obvious, that is the very complex security issue is very nice. Very important things, but because the lots of systems will work here simultaneously, so that is the issue of the security. And the susceptible, manageability, obvious, अगर हम किसी एक सिस्टम को मैनेज कर तो इजीली उसको हैंडल कर सकते हैं, बट यहाँ पर हम मिलियंस ऑफ नोड हैं से नेटवर्क में, उनको मैनेज करने में कहीं ना कहीं कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी आती है और बहुत थोड़ा टिपिकल हो जाता है. सेटअप करने में भी कॉस्ट वाइज भी बहुत प्रॉब्लम है, क्योंकि कॉस्ट में उसकी डिस्ट्रीब्यूट सिस्टम की बहुत ज़्यादा आने वाली है, बहुत सारे इशूज हैं. बट रादर देन द डिसएडवांटेज, एडवांटेज वेरी मोर फोकसेबल थिंग्स दैट बाई विच वी आर एबल टू कम्युनिकेट बाई मास पासिंग द मैसेज थ्रू वन प्लेस टू अनदर अक्रॉस द ग्लोब. सो दैट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द एंड एडवांटेज डिसएडवांटेज फीचर्स एंड आर्किटेक्चर एवरीथिंग दैट इज द related to distributed system. So thank you for watching this video. For more videos, subscribe the channel. In the next video we will see what kind of the scenario, what is the types of the algorithms are used in the distributed system, and what are the different types of the architecture are used, what are the types of the mapping are used. So we will see in the later. Thank you for watching this video.